Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'm going to show you a prefecture which belongs to a region of central Greece. It's called the Evia Prefecture, and it has two islands. Evia Island, which is the second largest island of Greece after Crete. It's 200 meters in a straight line from the north to the south, very close to Athens. It's just 1 hour if you take the highway from Athens and go to the center of the island. Also, you can reach it at the south with ferry boats. In 20 minutes from the airport, you are at the port, and you go to the south in 45 minutes. And in 1 hour and a half, you go to the north by highway, and then you pass again with the ferry in half an hour, and you are there. So it's very close. It's the special island for alternative tourism, because there's the tourism is easy tourism. It's not a massive tourism, not many big buildings, big hotels, just small hotels. And the nature is very nice because there's a big variety of the nature. In the north, it's full of green. And as you go to the south, it looks like Cyclades islands. Not very, too much green, but just rocks. And there is a big history because there are two ancient, just a moment, yes. This is to the center, to the capital of the island, which is in just in the center of the island, and it's connected with two bridges, with the mainland. This is the new one, and this is the old one. Here there's a tidal phenomenon, where the water goes, change direction every 6 hours, and the hours are the exact time, and this is the strange thing, and many people, they come and they study about this phenomenon to see why it happens like this. Some pictures from the capital, and here is Eretria. It's another town which was very important in the ancient times. There is a theater here, an ancient theater, and after 2-3 years it's going to work, and we have a place there, tragedies and etc. Some icons, some images from beaches. The beaches are virgin ones. They are not organized, so but they are very nice, with green and blue waters. Wineries, this is a monastery, this is all Portan. There are some Venetian towers on the island. This is the inside. This is Dirfis, which is the highest mountain of the island, and there are many paths there, and it's very nice during the winter also. And this is on the north. It's a place for ecology tourism with very small hotels for families, and you can enjoy here. And this is a very small island, which is, we call it Seychelles of Greece, because if you look up from the over it, you think that it's like in Seychelles. The beaches are fantastic. You can go in 15 minutes from the mainland with a boat, or from the north side, you can go in 10 minutes. This is the most important town on the north. It's very famous because of the thermal springs, and it's called Edipsos. You see the people, they are just under the water, and they go to be cured or for mutinies. There are many hotels there with the spine site. And this is these figs are grain figs, which are very famous in all Greece, and they produce there in this island. It's very known for the seafood. There are many gorges, like the Mosaic Gorge, which is very good for trekking, scuba diving, kite surfing, 4x4 if you want. And these are called dragon houses because it's from ancient times. The stones are very long and very heavy ones, and they are not connected with any material, each one with the other. And that's why we say that maybe dragons, they build these houses. This is a complex of 10 islands which is in the south. They are private ones. Picasso has bought one here. And this is again to the Mosaic Gorge. And this is Skyros, the other small island which was just next to Evia. And it's a very small island, but a very nice nature, similar to Evia. The town is very nice because it has a nice view to the sea. And here there lives a race of these ponies. It comes from ancient times, and still we preserve this race, and families go there with their children and for riding and etc. I hope to enjoy it and come to Evia whenever you like, or to Skiros. You are welcoming, and you have a good time if you want to have alternative tourism and many things to do, other activities. Thank you.
Danke, vielen Dank. Also wir gehen jetzt rüber von Evia nach Evrytania. Evrytania ist der zweite größte Gebiet, also nordwestlich von Athen, ungefähr 3,5 Stunden weiter weg von Athen. Sie werden zwei Videos sehen und eine kleine Einladung auf Englisch, und danach kommt Arachova. Okay, danke.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I would like to welcome you to Evrytania. A very well kept secret among the Greeks is considered to be the Greek Alps or the Switzerland of Greece. So you don't have to go very far away to find the mountains and the beautiful views. You can always come to Greece and think of Greece as something else behind what you have in your mind. It's called Karpenissi, the capital town, and it's called the island on the altitude of 1,000 meters. As you can see, we don't have anything. We can boast ourselves as the Greek Alps and the Switzerland of Greece. It's an all-season destination, even for summer and for winter. And its location is exactly in the center of Greece, equally distant from Thessaloniki or Athens. It's time for you to think, discover, and experience Evrytania. Video of what you can see and what you can do during the summertime, and especially from April to December. And now we will show you what you actually can do in winter. Thank you.
qué?
Now you see why you are called the Greek Alps or the Switzerland of Greece. And that the exact is an island of 1,000 liters. Carlos, I will follow you with Arajo.
Vielen Dank. Jetzt also die dritte Darstellung. Es gibt ein Ort in der Nähe von Athen, ist 1,5 Stunden weiter weg, 168 Kilometer, heißt Arachova. Ist ein Skigebietort, aber man kann auch während des ganzen Jahres da ganz tolle Sachen machen, wie Trekking, Wanderurlaub machen. Auch noch Bicycle-Touren machen. Es ist das Chamonix oder der St. Moritz von Griechenland. Der Ort, wie man sieht von Athen, hier ist der ganz oben rechts auf Parnassos. Parnassos ist das Gebirge, wo man auch Skifahren kann, ist das größte Skigebiet Griechenlands. Und dann werde ich Ihnen eine 2,5 Minuten Video zeigen, damit Sie ungefähr eine Idee bekommen. Danke.
So schön kann Griechenland im Winter sein. Unglaublich, oder? Das soll man gar nicht glauben.